there, his middle son Rudolph came strolling across in front of the house. Father Kotelheimer said to himself, "Just look at the fellow. He doesn't do much work, but he eats a lot. There's no profit in keeping such a son. I'll throw him out. The farmer called his wife over and told her about getting rid of his middle son. Kotelheimer did not know it, but the son was standing close by. The son had heard his father. Then the farmer's wife said, "Good, he never obeys me. Get rid of him." Rudolph's tail stood straight up. "What a horrible idea. Thrown out. Ghastly." He trotted quietly to the back of the house and then out onto the wood. "I'll show them," he said to himself. "I'll go to Bremen and become a famous rock singer. They'll be sorry when I'm rich and famous." As Rudolph strolled slowly down the road to Bremen, he saw a skinny young man walking ahead of him slowly. His shoulders drooped. "Hey, you," called Rudolph. "Where are you going? What's the matter? You look terribly droopy." "You look droopy too if you had a master like mine," answered the young man. "Tell me all about it," said Rudolph. "It's this way," the skinny young man started his story. "I was born on the farm you just passed. My mother and father were born there too. My family served our master well for many years. We hunted with him, worked in his field, guarded his house and his children. Now he says I'm useless. He said I don't work hard enough. He says I don't earn my food. Do you know what he actually said?" he asked. "No," answered Rudolph. After all those years of work and devotion, he said that he was going to take me out into the wood and shoot me." "That's awful," exclaimed Rudolph. "Something like that happened to me too." Then he told the young man his sad story. "Finally," he said, "friend, I'm on my way to Bremen to become a famous rock singer. Come with me. We can be a famous rock duet." "Great," said the young man. He straightened his shoulders and felt much better. Singing a duet, the two proceeded down the road to Bremen. It was a dreadful duet. Then the two fellows saw a young girl standing outside a farmhouse gate. She screamed, "Stop that horrible noise! Stop it! Keep quiet!" The two stopped singing. "That's an insult!" exclaimed Rudolph. "Yes, an insult," agreed the other. "We are about to become a famous rock duet in Bremen, so be nice to us. We are going to be rich and famous." "I was thinking about going to Bremen too," said the girl. "I've been going fast lately, and my mistress can't get me on trains and buses at half fare anymore. She's been feeding me less and less to keep me small. I'm getting awfully hungry. May I join you? We could make it a trio." "Great idea," said Rudolph. "Yeah, great idea," said the other. The trio continued along the road to Bremen. They sang as they went. The trio sounded better than duet. After a while, they saw a quite unattractive young man by the side of the road. He was just staring into space. "Hi," called Rudolph. There was no answer. "Hey, you," called Rudolph. "What's the matter with you? Answer me."
I'm not talking to anyone,
answered the young fellow.
"Why not?" asked the girl. "All the other kids were going to a party. I wasn't invited."
"I'm miserable," he answered. "I think I won't wait."
"Fine," said the trio. "Come with us. We're going to Bremen to become a famous rock singer. We're going to be the best rock trio in Bremen."
"Great," exclaimed the newcomer. "We can be the greatest rock quartet.
I'm a very good singer."
The quartet sang off together. Singing, the four continued on the road to Bremen. They sounded terrible. They were out of tune, the time was off, and they were singing different songs. One might sing, "I love you," while others were singing, "Doe, a female deer." Just as it got dark, Rudolph said, "I'm sure we're getting hungry. How about you three?" They answered, "You sure are getting hungry." "Let's rush for a house," said Rudolph. "Maybe we can get something to eat." "Good idea," said one, so they started looking for a house. But they did not see one for a long time. Suddenly, the droopy fellow flew into the wood and said, "Look, there's a light. It must be a house."
"It sure is," said Rudolph. "You stay here. I'll go check it."
He walked very quietly, but he didn't need to because there was a lot of noise coming from the house. He sneaked up into a window and looking, he saw a band of robbers eating and drinking and looking at things they had stolen. Rudolph went back to his companions and told them what he had seen.
"I want to get some of the food," said the girl.
"Okay, let's go over to the house," said Rudolph. "Let's figure out how to steal food from the robbers." They walked to the house and looked in.
"I can see a thing," said the girl. "I'm too short."
"Me too," said the other two. "Shh," said Rudolph. Then he whispered, "Climb up on my back. Then you can see in." All three started to climb up on his back. As the last one climbed up, Rudolph yelled, "Ouch, you're hurting me." Immediately, robbers stopped their yelling and singing.
"What was that?" cried one of them. "There's something out there," said another.
"Look, it's a monster. It's huge, and it has snakes for hair."
Actually, what had happened was this. One after another, the three climbed up on Rudolph's shoulders, with the girl on top.
Her curse looked like snakes to the drunken robber.
"Attack the monster," yelled one of the robbers. Another yelled, "Let's go." Rudolph dumped his companions on the ground as the robbers came running out of the house. The courtyard was in a panic. A robber came rushing toward them. Rudolph hit him with a stick. A girl scratched another robber's face, and Rudolph yelled, "Run! Run for your lives!" The robber thought it was a robber yelling, so they ran away faster.